donne la parole à Monsieur Geert Haarde, ancien Premier ministre d'Islande.
Dear Madame Rajavi, ladies and gentlemen, and dear friends, I think we probably reached the point at this conference where all the important points have already been made. There may not be much new to add. But let me say that for somebody like myself, who is relatively new to the problems of Ashraf and the related difficulties that have been discussed here today, listening to these speeches here has been absolutely eye-opening. These have been very informative and revealing speeches, and I have learned a lot by simply listening here today. And these achievements have been based, I think, on the tireless, the courageous, and yet flexible work and efforts of Madame Rajavi and her people in the pro-democracy movement, but also on an international campaign which has included parliamentarians from many countries. Of course, the extension of the deadline for closing the camp was enormously important. But as other speakers have pointed out repeatedly, so much more remains to be done. And there are still problems that would have been out of the way if everyone had abided by the agreements and the MOUs reached. Unfortunately, this is not the case. Prime Minister al-Maliki and his government must honor their obligations in this regard, and turning the new camp, as has been described here today, in effect into a prison with overcrowded and insufficient facilities and living quarters is simply not acceptable. And at the risk of sounding repetitive with respect to the other speakers, I will say what many people have already said once again. The US must remove MEK from its list of terrorist organizations. It's an insult. It's an insult to people's intelligence that this has not been done already. And it's good to hear how our American friends on this panel today regard this problem and how determined they are to get it solved. Just get to work and get it done. Whisper into Hillary Clinton's ear or whatever it takes. Given the history of US involvement in Iraq since 2003, and in particular, given the individual contracts that were made with the residents, the US responsibility in this matter is enormous. And I think the speech made by General Phillips here was a tremendously courageous statement from a man who was on the ground, from a man who knows exactly what was going on, and from a man who perhaps is a little ashamed of what has happened on the part of his own government since he was on the ground. I appreciate that statement and also what his daughter said here. Dear friends, let's not forget when it comes to Iran itself that the people who live there want a regime change. They want a peaceful transfer of power away from the religious dictatorship that now rules their country towards a pluralistic, truly democratic, secular and open society. A non-nuclear Iran. And in the longer term perspective of the great historical perspective of the great Persian people, the current mullah regime will surely and hopefully be seen as a temporary phenomenon to be swept away by the forces of history. The National Council of Resistance of Iran, Madame Rajavi and her people have prepared a blueprint for such a new era based on the rule of law with unimpeded freedom of expression, freedom of assembly and religion, and other such basic rights that are sought and cherished by supporters of democracy all over the world, and which include the rights of women in all walks of life. All of us must strongly support all relevant moves in this direction and push for the regime change that is so necessary. Thank you.